of justice.
Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, so one thing, that's interesting. So one of the things that I feel like I will tell you is this, okay? Guys, you gotta be an active audience, dude, listen, because there might be some questions on this coming down the pipe at you later on. So one of the things that I want you guys to make sure you do, I don't know, and I'm not trying to be stupid or anything, but when you open up your slides presentation, some people don't know how to actually open it up. It might not come up all the way. Just make sure that that window that says agriculture right next to it on the top, Tanner, you can shut your screen, but don't shut this because this is the main classroom screen. Don't shut that one, okay? Doesn't matter what else you shut, don't shut that one. All right, so guys, I gotta listen, you gotta listen. The reason that I gotta listen is I gotta write this down, all right? Or at least that's the plan. So all I'm doing is paying attention just like you should be. Tanner gave you a one-page summary handout of his presentation, which should have the highlights in it. And just...
Everything you need to know is on that sheet, basically.
Pretty much, that's it.
The summary.
Okay, so Tanner, do you know what you do?
Yep, we're ready.
Whenever you're ready.
Let's talk tractors. Invention of the tractor. The first gas-powered tractor was invented in 1892. It was called the Froehlich tractor. This is the man responsible, John Froehlich. He was the original inventor of the gas-powered tractor, hence the name Froehlich tractor. Froehlich was American and he attended the College of Iowa. Location. The tractor was invented in Froehlich's home country, the United States of America. To go even further, the tractor was truly invented in a small village located in northeast Iowa. What does it do? Tractors can be used for various agricultural tasks. It's a massive piece of machinery that is usually put into hauling materials, plowing, fertilizing, harvesting crops, and planting. How does a tractor operate? The heart of a farm tractor is a powerful internal combustion engine. Diesel and spark-driven engines are both found on tractors. There's an image of both. Power is transmitted through a propeller shaft to a gearbox and then to two large rear drive wheels. Advancements over time. In hindsight, right here in the bottom left, the first tractor looks to have some serious safety issues compared to our John Deere of today. There isn't any protective glass or protection over the engine. Massive tires provided for less rust and internal damage. The engine on this one is exposed. The tires obviously look a lot more unsafe, and it's a smaller structure as a whole. How is the tractor made life easier for farmers? Tractors bring increased efficiency and productivity. These advancements, farms are able to grow and expand. According to Wessel's Living History Farm, this is a fun fact. The time it took to plow an acre of land shrank from an hour and a half using 5 horses to 30 minutes using a 27 horsepower tractor. And this was my honest reaction to that information. This is the evolution of a tractor, obviously the first one from 1892, the original model. The Big Bud from 77, a massive piece of machinery. And the Quad Track from 1996. Here's a little video of... I'm gonna watch this whole thing in the long video. It is a simulator, but it matches real life. Yes, I can. Anyway, this is the last slide. Anyway, a new model. This is the 2023 6R 165 John Deere tractor. And we see the difference between this model and the original model from 130 years ago. Quite a big difference. Again, I'll go back to that original model right here. On display in museums. And there's the references, that's it.
Yeah, close those up.